This is the SAP Developer News for August 1st, 2024.
The July edition of SAP BTP InnoBytes is out now. If you didn't know already, you should know, SAP BTP InnoBytes is a monthly series of videos bringing you snackable, up-to-date information about innovations on SAP BTP. This month, we see items on security and identity, and also on the SAP Task Center. So first of all, the SAP Secure Login Service for SAP GUI has some enhancements allowing you to connect to and use customer-managed certificate authorities. There's support already for AWS private CAs, with more options in the roadmap. With SAP Cloud Identity Services, there are some enhancements to allow you to define user group assignments at the application level, on top of the already existing user profile and tenant levels. And finally, with the SAP Task Center, there are some innovations allowing you now to bring in and use task providers from non-SAP and legacy systems, bringing a much asked for unified task view. Find out more about these innovations in the InnoBytes July edition. Link is in the description. And by the way, it's the end of July, just starting August, which means that the reverse APIs challenge is now coming to an end. You can still work through the tasks, but we've got an amazing challenge coming up for you for the month of August. And I'm going to hand over to my lovely friend and colleague, Shilpa, to tell you all about it. Shilpa, over to you.
Thanks, DJ, in passing the SAP Developer Challenge. I must admit, you kept the SAP community hungry in releasing 11 tasks in your challenge. Me and Sheena will try to keep up the legacy in making an interesting August developer challenge. So with that, hello everyone. You might have seen the ongoing SAP TechBytes series on ABAP Core Data Services. So with that, it's a good idea to have the developer challenge related to ABAP CDS. Watch out for every Wednesday where a new task will be released. There's a prerequisite which will help you to get started with this challenge. Now this blog post gives the information about the challenge, quick links, help document and the timeline as and when the task is updated. Check out the blog post, make sure to complete the prerequisite and be ready for the challenge.
Hey folks, Rich Allman here. Have you heard? Registration for SAP TechEd Virtual 2024 is now open, and I'm not the only one that gets excited about this time of year. My best friend Sully also loves TechEd time, and he's gearing up as well. SAP TechEd Virtual 2024 will be packed with a ton of information for architects and developers, ranging from lectures and jumpstart sessions, from voice of the partner sessions to keynotes, and of course, your very own developer keynote, which we are changing up a bit this year and having more of a deconstructed approach to the developer keynote. So stay tuned for more details on that. So make sure to sign up for SAP TechEd Virtual, which takes place on October 8th and 9th. And also stay tuned for more information around the SAP TechEd on Tour stops starting in November. And lastly, don't forget about DevToberfest, which starts 2 weeks prior to the start of SAP TechEd Virtual and picks back up for an additional 2 weeks after the SAP TechEd Virtual event. And as always, your developer advocate team will be playing a huge role in both DevToberfest and SAP TechEd in general. And we are all really excited to see all of you soon. Bye for now.
Hello, SAP developers. We are happy to announce some major UX enhancements on Joule within SAP Build Core. The new design brings a more intuitive user interface, which enhances usability and brings in streamlined workflows. Before the update, triggering Joule required navigating through specific entry points like the guide setter or the enhance button in the data editor. It also meant switching between separate chats for different tasks. With the new design, Joule has a single interface for all functionalities, making it easy to switch between tasks. There are some great new features to make all of this possible. Slash Comments lets you generate a Fiori Limits application, get help on SAP UI5 topics, generate a CAP application, add sample data and logic to it. Context Variables allows you to use hash symbol in combination with slash commands to reference existing project files. The Dynamic Suggestion features shows developers' previous actions automatically. A new file management feature allows you to see which files Joule is using for code generation, both during and after the process. A new file list block component allows developers to check the quality of the generated code in the files when multiple files are generated. Custom action buttons allows you to quickly navigate to various interfaces of build code and edit the generated results. If you want to dig deeper into these features, our design lead of SAP Build Code, Ivan, has written this blog post about it. We would love to hear your feedback on these topics.